My address isn't registered, so I can't get mail. My phone doesn't work, so my service towers are not registering with the area. PSE&G doesn't recognize my address, so I can't register my utilities. Constant fireworks and shootouts. My neighbors are sitting here smoking weed all the time, therefore I can smell it through the vents. My neighbors are sitting here having cookouts in the garage, spray painting shit in the garage so I can smell the spray paint through my vents. They're sitting here doing hair in the garage. Car washes in the garage, illegal tenants, constant domestic disputes that are leading to excessive police presence, alleged trap houses all around the complex that are leading to excessive police presence. Of course, I saw roaches as I was packing to leave, which made no sense, and I knew they wasn't coming for me because them shits had dust on them and it was coming from the light sockets. Ring notifications that was telling me about the constant shootings and stabbings that were not on the news, because if you have a Ring, it's like a neighborhood watch and they tell you everything that's going on. Sitting here blocking my driveway on a constant, consistent basis. I don't got time for that goofy shit. Way too much fucking rent for people to be blocking my driveway. From what I understand, I'm the only one consistently paying rent early. Don't block my fucking driveway. These people are sitting here partying on the steps, y'all. I'm talking about like these steps are not big, guys. Like these steps are literally smaller than my couch. Like y'all see my YouTube couch, you seen how big it is. Smaller than my YouTube couch. Let that sink in. They're sitting here smoking hookah, drinking alcohol, partying on the steps. The hallways are dirty and everything, so child, it's just a baby trap house in the making. What up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel, and today we are going to be talking about how I moved yet again. Now you guys are probably sitting here like, bruh, no, you did not. Like, what the fuck? Yes. But for a lot of you guys who are OG subscribers, you would know that I did move because you've been tuning into my lives on both Bego as well as this channel, because I have told this story a couple times. So also make sure you guys follow me on Instagram as well as just peep the description box for all the important information that you guys always ask me for on a regular basis. I also have to give a very genuine and sincere apology for a lot of my behavior and absentee this entire year, because I really have realized that a lot of my behavior as well as breaks this year have been contributed to my environment. I have been ridiculously stressed and just wholeheartedly depressed and did not realize it till like I was essentially coming out of the depression. I have been disassociating. I have been so drained and emotionally gone and distant. And it's all because of this apartment. You guys may think I'm being extra. You guys may think that this is a lot. You guys may think that I'm over exaggerating. But when you hear the rest of the story, I guarantee you it's not extra and I'm not over exaggerating. So I have to tell you right now, if you did not already, go get your tea, go get your snacks, go get everything you need, because this is gonna be a very long story. I'm going to go into detail and there's a lot going on here.
Child, what the fuck? Wait, what is going on? Hold up, they about to raid the house? They not about to come in the house. They not about to come in the house. Yo, I think they about to come in the. Yo! Someone getting arrested over there.
am very, very private. And this has nothing to do with just the internet. I'm just like that. So I have to give another apology to the people that are closest to me in my life that I did not go into detail with regarding all of this. I just didn't want to be a burden, and I did not necessarily want to just come off as if I was complaining, didn't want to come off as a brat, and didn't want to come off as like superficial, because I really thought that all of this was just small. But then I realized that honestly I was in denial about a lot of this, and to be honest, nobody should be living like this. So if you guys watched my previous story time regarding my landlord, the reason I have not updated any of this is because he's MIA, okay? This man is disappeared. The property management of that condo association wants to foreclose on the unit, but of course, because of COVID and everything, and plus since he's not answering, there is nothing they can do about that, and I can't find him in order to sue him and get my security deposit back. So honestly, there's a whole thing with that. He tried to relist the unit and tried to rent it back out. I went there. Listen, it's a whole hoopla with that. I got footage. That's on pause for right now. But let me just say, I've had issues with landlords. Never in my life have I had neighbor issues. I've never had ghetto neighbors. I've never had bad neighbors, but I've had horrible landlord situations. I also have to note that I've never really been afraid for my life. I've been annoyed with the hood. The hood has always been something that annoyed me. Hence, I always had this whole mindset of, I don't mind living in the hood. As long as my apartment's nice and I mind my business, I don't give a fuck, because at the end of the day, no one's gonna do shit to me, because if you mind your business in the hood, nothing's gonna happen to you. Because where I come from in my hood, we don't do shit to each other. We do shit to everyone else in other places, because that's the type of hood I come from. And I've come to the conclusion that when you come from the hood and in the hood, there's different levels to the shit, okay? There's the hood, there's trenches, then there's the projects. And then within that, there's like community type of hood, and then there's community type of projects. Then there's like Robin Hood type of hoods. Then there's the hood type of hood where like anyone and everybody gets hurt. Then there's like, we're not gonna do shit to our own. We're gonna do shit to everybody else. And then there's the like, you know, we're gonna do shit to other people and make sure our people benefit from it. You know, there's different types of levels to this shit. This shit right here is some shit I ain't never done seen in my entire life right here. Where I was at, guys, this was not the regular type of hood. This was legitimately the trench. These people was doing all types of goofy shit, and people around were complaining about them. And they were conspiring with other people to make sure shit was happening to other people around in terms of cars getting stolen, fucking doing shit to this, that, and the third, making people shit was getting robbed. And people were complaining. And I'm sitting here, like, unbeknownst to me, my little happy ass, I'm either inside at the gym in New York, in PA, I'm chilling. It wasn't until I started complaining that I was getting fed this information. And I'm sitting here like, wait, what? How the fuck is this happening? And I did not know any of this is happening, bro. This was not the same thing as a regular hood. And on top of that, this is not like any type of hood that I've been from. This is not the same type of thing. And understand that this was Newark. I also come from Elizabeth. I was born in New York. Okay, I was born in Long Island. However, I was raised in Elizabeth my entire life, and I came from Elizabeth, and I lived in Newark for a couple of years. However, when I first moved to Newark, I was in Weequake, and then I'm not gonna divulge where I was before, because that's gonna give too much information away. However, this was a completely different section of Newark, and just a couple of lessons that I'm gonna give, because I know a lot of people are probably not gonna watch this the whole entire way through. I do suggest everyone watch this entire video so you guys can understand the context and understand where I'm coming from. I'm going to give a lot of the lessons before I go through the entire video. One, please research where you're gonna live. My case is I was moving from an emergency situation where my landlord did not pay their dues, and I had to move because the city was closing in and that, and I didn't want to be out on the street and be forced to leave. Also, it was one of those situations where I did not have time to really research because, you know, blah, 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 COVID and all of that. Always research where you live. For those of you who are going to be like,
oh, please just move into a house at this point.
You guys are acting like you can't have shitty neighbors and you can't have like shitty situations happening to you when you move into a house. That's absolutely incorrect. And a lot of you guys telling me to buy a house don't have a house. So I suggest you shut up. It doesn't make any logical sense. You don't have a house. Also, I personally don't want the responsibilities of having a house, snow removal, gutter cleaning, and all these other things that a lot of guys do not think about. I don't want that. I'm also in a very serious relationship that's moving towards marriage right now. I want to be able to do that with my husband, and I want to be able to buy a house when I am ready to go towards that step. I want to be able to do that with my husband. I want to be able to do that when I'm ready to have a family. I don't want to do that right now. That's my personal choice. You do what you do with your life. I'm gonna do what I wanna do with mine. I don't want a house right now, and that's okay. This whole situation also got to the point where I was very afraid for my life. My mental health was very, very bad. And thank God for medication, because I feel like I would have been checked into a psych ward if I was not on medication. That's how bad all of this got. I was afraid for not only my own safety, but the safety of my guests. It got to the point where I was afraid that every single time they left my house, every time I invited someone to my house, to the point where I just didn't invite anyone to my house. So I kind of isolated myself. The only person that was constantly coming to my house was my man, and I was very, very afraid for him anytime he didn't find parking directly in front of my house. And I'm going to tell you a couple of stories, and you're gonna be like, oh my God, like even him parking in front of my house was like a very scary thing. I also have to note that a lot of these situations I have brought to the property management and other people that should have and did not rectify the situation. I have always rented black, okay? All of my landlords have been black, even when it comes to my parents, except for up to recently where their building has been bought by a Jewish person, okay? All of my landlords have been black, property managers have been black. Up to right now where I'm living, they are not black. Everything's black. My lashes right now, black business. Hortense, hibiscus. My lipstick right now, black. The lip bar. I am very conscientious of supporting good business and black business. So what we're not gonna do is try to sit up in here and try to act like I'm trying to like put people down and talk shit and thot, thot, thot. That's what we're not gonna do. What we're not gonna do is try to act like we know how to handle ourselves accordingly when we have good shit. This is a very serious situation, and I don't play about my money, my mental health, the safety of myself and my guests. I don't like to talk. When shit is coming to the point where I'm paying you and shit is not getting rectified, I get real, real fucking upset, and I don't like when people are all up in my motherfucking face and I feel like I'm being plotted against. And most importantly, I don't like throwing thousands of dollars to people and they not doing shit with it. When I first moved and I knew I fucked up, when literally within a week of me moving there, niggas was jumping on cars. Yes. I first moved into that apartment and there was a bunch of teenage kids running around and jumping on the street, yelling, screaming, jumping on the cars on the street right in front of the building, like right in front of where I live, jumping on the street, screaming. I don't know if they just graduated or what. And you guys are probably like, why didn't you call the cops? Why didn't you do something, bro? I kid you not, it was at least 30 kids. And I didn't want to fuck around and call the cops. And this is like around the time where that whole situation happened with like George Floyd and stuff. So I'm like, I don't want to be the one to call the cops. Next thing you know, something happens to one of these kids, they become a hashtag, and I'm the one that called the cops on them. Next thing you know, people are skewing the story like, oh, I'm the Karen that called the cops and one of these kids got killed. You see how bad that story would sound instead of me telling the story the way I just told it? You know, like now I hope that person's car is okay, because a whole bunch of kids really just was playing music and celebrating God knows what. I don't know what they were doing all of that for, but they were literally just jumping on cars, playing music, and it was just unacceptable. Like, it was, oh Lord, y'all, it was bad. It was very fucking bad. Now, let me just let you guys know, I did not break my lease, not ever. My lease was over May 2021 and I did not sign another lease. I told these people I am not signing another lease due to all of the bullshit tomfoolery you guys are putting me through. I will not sign another lease, I promise you that. I'm looking for another place, but since you guys are not rectifying, you guys are not working with me, yeah, I'm looking for another place. So we have to give people names in this story. First, we have the property manager. We're going to call him Michael. Now, Michael is the same property manager who was the property manager at the previous place with what we're gonna call, I don't remember what I called him in the last story time of the last building, my last landlord that I had at the last place where, you know, we're trying to sue the last person. So yes, we have Michael. So Michael helped me get into this place, also a real estate agent, and he helped me get into this apartment. Now this apartment is beautiful. Okay, as you guys can see, it was definitely an upgrade to this last apartment that I had. Beautiful 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom apartment. Gorgeous, amazing, whatever. Now I can definitely say I did not care for this apartment because one, it was an extra bedroom that I did not need and I did not want. However, it was the same exact price. They gave me a discount on it because again, it was an emergency move. Loved it, whatever. And I was honestly very much so struggling to find another 2-bedroom, 2-bath in my same price range in an area that I cared for, that I liked. Now I can definitely say it was definitely out of my way. But like I said, it was easier to get, it was easier to find. Honestly, it was a hookup, so I took it. I did not do the research. I did not really care where it was because at the time, for me, it was like, well, it's in Newark and it's easier to get because Michael's the one giving it to me, so I'm just gonna take it. Don't ever do that, guys. Take my warning. Always research where you're going to live because you're gonna end up in the same bullshit that I was in. Do not ever do that. Now, I'm just gonna say that I definitely did not care because, like I said, I grew up in the hood. So for me, it was like, I don't give a fuck where it is. As long as I have somewhere to sleep, I don't give a fuck. Nothing's gonna happen to me. And yeah, don't do that. Just do not do that because quality of life is very important. I feel like since I'm getting older now, it's more so important for me. And since I film, it's 10 times more important for me. So let's just go over the issues before we go into the details of the issues. My address isn't registered, so I can't get mail. My phone doesn't work, so my service towers are not registering with the area. PSENG doesn't recognize my address, so I can't register my utilities. Constant fireworks and shootouts. My neighbors are sitting here smoking weed all the time, therefore I can smell it through the vents. My neighbors are sitting here having cookouts in the garage, spray painting shit in the garage so I can smell the spray paint through my vents. They're sitting here doing hair in the garage, car washes in the garage, illegal tenants, constant domestic disputes that are leading to excessive police presence, alleged trap houses all around the complex that are leading to excessive police presence. Of course, I saw roaches as I was packing to leave, which made no sense, and I knew they wasn't coming for me because them shits had dust on them and it was coming from the light sockets. People out here just willy-nilly ringing my doorbell, knocking on my door because push over. My neighbor downstairs had the nerve, the gall, the audacity to just give the garage code to the whole city of fucking Newark. This girl would also have this nonsensical habit of anytime she wanted me, anytime she needed me, she would just ring my doorbell. I don't know why she can't just knock on my door, but this is what she would fucking do. So I'm thinking that's what's happening. This is the thing, right? My guests are not dumb enough to just come to my door. When people come see me, they know to contact me, okay, via text message. They would never just pop up to my house because I don't do pop-ups, I don't do pull-ups, I do not do unexpected visits. I do let me know within a week in advance what time you're coming, what day you're coming, is that it? I do not do unexpected visits. Don't fucking do that to me. I'm not answering the fucking door. Okay, I don't do that shit. So anytime they would ring my doorbell and shit like that, I'm not answering it. I don't give a fuck. Ring notifications that was telling me about the constant shootings and stabbings that were not on the news, because if you have a Ring, it's like a neighborhood watch and they tell you everything that's going on. Sitting here blocking my driveway on a constant, consistent basis. I don't got time for that goofy shit. Way too much fucking rent for people to be blocking my driveway. From what I understand, I'm the only one consistently paying rent early. Don't block my fucking driveway. The hallways are dirty and everything, so child, it's just a baby trap house in the making. So what's interesting is when I first moved into this house or whatever, I thought this was gonna be great because it was brand spanking new. It was a brand new development situation. So I thought this is gonna be great. It's nice, it's brand new. And it was kind of like the start of a gentrification type of situation. I had no idea it was the hood because when I first saw this apartment, it was like brand new in the morning. There was no type of activity around. Across the street, it was like also a brand new like type of development thing where there was gonna be businesses across the street. So I thought, okay, this is gonna be great. Like everything is brand new. Everything is gonna be like, yo, like I was like, this is so nice. I'm gonna be part of something brand new. I'm gonna be part of like brand new gentrification. So the way this is set up, there is 9 different units, right? So I was showed a corner unit. This is very important because you're gonna be like, y'all, Ivana does the bullet. But I was still dealt a bunch of bullets because 9 different units. And the way it works in Jersey is there's complexes, there's houses, and then there's like these things. I don't know what these are considered, but like it's like they look like houses, but they're like apartments in these houses. So there's 9. There's 3 in each, and each set of 3 has different owners. So they showed me the corner one, and the corner one had like more windows. And you guys know I'm a demon. I don't like windows. So they showed me and I was like, oh, there's so many windows in here. Because yeah, I don't like windows. Like I said, I'm a demon. And personally, when something has more windows, that means more money because I'm gonna have to buy more curtains. And that also means more electricity bill because more light means more sun, which means more AC, which means more heat cost. I mean, it depends on who you are, right? Like personally, I just like less light to come in. Like that's just me. I just don't like it. So there was like, oh, we have another one that looks exactly identical, but it has way less windows because it's in the middle. It's directly in the middle. I was like, okay, show me that. I got to see everything first. So I saw every single apartment before anybody did. I was the first one there. There was absolutely no tenants. Keep that in mind. It is extremely important to this story. So I saw my unit. Fell in love. I loved it, even though it looked exactly like the other one, but it had no windows, so it was perfect for me because that meant less light. So I picked it, loved it, you know. I think I did like some sort of like background check situation online, whatever, got approved. And, you know, did all the process, whatever. And by then, he was like, yeah, you know, we're still trying to get some people, yada, yada, yada. And he was like, yeah, we still can't find anyone yet. You know, you're looking like, you know, you're going to be the only one here, ta, ta, ta. And then literally last minute, kid you not, it was probably like a couple days before, all of a sudden, there was all of these people that all of a sudden had spots. All of a sudden, the building was full. So I moved in May 1st, 2020. But I remember, if you guys remember, if you guys follow me on Instagram, you would know that I had moving issues and I had to drag my past moving company. Yes, I had another moving issue this year. So you guys are gonna get another story time because I have to drag this moving company and I'm dragging them by name and I'm dragging them for film. I have a phone call and everything because they were very rude. I had to do a Google fucking shit for them too because they tried me. They fucking tried me and then they broke my shit. And then they lost some shit. So they're going to get I've been a dormant dragon this year. I've been letting people fucking try me, but not anymore. But anyway, I was confused because all of a sudden, all of these people just magically appeared. And my thing is, I didn't know where he got these people from. It didn't make sense because you guys had absolutely no one. I got approved and then within a couple of days, all of these people, all 9 units were full. That's very strange to me. I don't know how you guys did it, but hey, whatever. So, you know, he tells me that my neighbor, which is directly under me, is a lady with a son, with a toddler. Now, we're gonna call her Pushover. Now, I'm gonna tell you guys why we're gonna call her Pushover in a little bit. We're gonna tell you guys why we're gonna call her Pushover. We're gonna tell you why. So this lady is so nice, you know? So I'm like, oh, okay, Pushover. So he's like, yeah, you know, her name is Pushover. You know, she has a son, you know, a toddler. And I'm like, ugh, kids. I love kids. You guys know I love kids. But I film and I'm just like, oh my God, how am I gonna film with a screaming baby?
Don't worry, he never cries. He's very, very quiet.
And she was right. I never really heard that baby cry. I probably heard that baby cry maybe 2 times out of the year in a couple of months I was there. I met that kid one time, never see that kid ever again. It was to the point where I was like, shit, should I call 911? Should I call CPS? Because I never seen the kid ever again. I never in my life seen a baby that quiet from the ages of 2 to 5. Kids are usually very, very destructive and very loud. At that age, I was actually very concerned. I don't know where they put that kid at. I was like, y'all put the kid in the stove. Y'all put the kid in the closet. Where is this kid at? I'm sorry. I don't mean to be like dark here, but where the fuck did y'all put that kid was that fucking quiet for that long? That shit is really actually concerning to me, like extremely concerning, knowing that her structure of her apartment is most likely just like mine. Her apartment is a 2-bedroom, 2-bath. Mine is a 3-bedroom, 2-bath. But the difference is she doesn't have that third bedroom. So her third bedroom is just wide open space. And the funny thing is when I saw her apartment, because like I said, I saw every single apartment. I remember specifically saying she has the ultimate party apartment because it was just wide open space, y'all. Like it really is the ultimate party apartment. Like it was just, it's big as fuck. Like it's just ultimate. Like y'all saw how big my apartment was. Can you imagine third bedroom? Non-existent. It was a small bedroom. However, can you imagine if they just knocked those walls out and just left it open? That's literally what her shit was. However, she had stairs leading downstairs. Okay? Stairs leading downstairs to ground level apartment. Now that's something else we're going to have to explain, because we have to then go into those neighbors down on the ground level. And we're gonna call them leg over. My baby give me leg over. And what's interesting is she was actually friends with leg over. Now these people were actually very, very peaceful. However, I do feel like they were kind of sketch towards the end. I'm gonna explain them a little bit and towards the end, because honestly they were very peaceful. I was gonna just call them peace. I'm gonna just call them leg over. My baby give me leg over. Because you know, sis was African and you know, they always talk about leg over. My baby leave me leg over. I never got to find out what African country sis was from, but she was like very, very nice. She was actually one of the first people to come over to me. Now, leg over had a man, okay? So her and her man lived downstairs. And what's very interesting is leg over was the first person to really get up in my face, okay? So leg over came up to me and was like,
oh my God, girl, you the girl that lives upstairs in the 3-bedroom all by herself?
So I'm just sitting there like, yeah. Now, I was very annoyed that anyone even knew that I was living in a 3-bedroom all by myself. That actually, now that I think about it, was actually pretty strange. I did not talk to a damn soul. I kid you not, I was there for maybe 3 days. And if you guys know anything about me, I'm a very in and out person. I'm sneaky like a fox. Okay, I'm a Capricorn. We sneaky like a fox. Ain't nobody knew me. Nobody even knew my name. Nobody knew me. So I was very confused as to how this girl knew that I was living in a 3-bedroom all the way upstairs. All by my, like, how does she know that? So I'm just sitting there like, wait. How does she know that I'm living in a 3? Yo, I was like, yeah. She was like,
oh girl, like, being all by yourself, like, you ain't got no man.
No.
What do you do?
I'm like, I work in social media.
Social media, girl, what are you doing?
I'm like, I do YouTube. She's like, girl, really? I'm like, yeah. She's like, oh, look, you're with your social media. You know, I'm like, oh God. I really don't like when people do that, because like, I kind of have to. Like, I'm not a liar. Like, I'm a really bad liar. And I'm like, oh yeah, here's my social media or whatever. She's like,
oh my God, girl, you teach me how to twerk.
And I'm like, fuck said that I twerk on social media. Why is it that every time I say I do social media, people automatically assume that I'm doing like sexual shit? So I'm just like, yeah, I got you, girl. Like, you got it, dude. I'm like, okay, girl. Like, girl, go ahead. Like, go ahead, girl. Go ahead, get down. I'm like, I mean, she was so nice though. She's honestly been very peaceful. Her and her man are really cool. Like, her man would actually volunteer to take the trash out and like put it to the actual street that, you know, the city registered. Honestly, Newark, y'all need to get it the fuck together. So since that street was forever never registered or something, I don't know what's up with that street, but I guess Newark just doesn't register it as a street. So it looks as if that street that that building was built on is not really registered or something like that to an extent. That building was an empty lot. before that building was there, which I'm gonna get into a little bit later. So the her husband, her boyfriend, honestly, I hear boyfriend, I hear husband, whatever, her man would go and like he would volunteer to take the trash and bring it around the corner. Very nice of him. So, you know, she would be like, yeah, you know, I'm here with my man. I'm like, oh, that's nice. So whatever, conversation over. So they were friends. So we had leg over, push over, they're friends. And this is very important because apparently property management thought it was very smart to put all of the people who live in the ground level and the middle level on the same lease. You guys are probably wondering why all of this has to be explained. Oh, it has to be explained because it's all gonna make sense. All 9 of these units are the same. Top units, most expensive, all individual leases. So 1, 2, 3 top levels, bottom levels, so middle and ground level leases are all combined leases. This is because the bottom levels are actually duplexes that have been made into singular apartments. You would think that if you're gonna make these apartments into singular apartments, you would go ahead and make these into singular leases. But for whatever reason, none of this coincided, made sense to these people. Just like for whatever logical reason, they went and took the laundries out of these duplexes. Okay, so since these were duplexes, there was only a laundry on the bottom. So the ground level had a laundry, but instead they took the laundry out of where it would have been and they put like little kitchens in there. So they went and put a full size oven in there and you can't even open it completely. Like it literally like just stops at the wall. And I'm like, you guys know how stupid that is? Like you guys could have just built the kitchen, like a small kitchen into the living room, because the living room is just like massively big. And they're like, no, it's fine. I'm like, no, that's ridiculous. Because anyone that really cooks, that's mad inconvenient that you can't even open the oven completely. Just like how I had that massively big ass touch screen fridge that they literally dented all the way coming up the fucking stairs. If you guys have me on Instagram, you would see that I was sitting there laughing at these dumbasses because they had to pay crackheads with crackhead strength to bring that fridge all the way up the stairs. And I was like, you know, honestly, I don't care for this fridge. You guys can just leave that shit on the ground level or leave it on the second floor, because like it's a very heavy fridge. And to be quite honest with you, it's massively unnecessary. It's ridiculous. It's way too heavy. And why? Like, I guess they're trying to compensate for the fact that it's in the middle of the hood and you know there's shootouts every day, but there's no reason for this fridge. And everything was just so stupid, so backward, like just so fucking unnecessary. We would use the garage as a front door because for whatever reason the property management thought it made sense to have the front door as a, you have to use the key to lock it and to open it. So if you use the front door to come out, you have to use the front door key to lock it again. Real stupid, real ridiculous. However, if you use the garage, you can literally just use it as a door. You could just use a code to open it and you just press the enter key to lock it again. Also left the garage door open. It would be too much to open the garage, come through, close the door, open the door, open the door. So we just leave that one door open as soon as you come through the garage. A lot of these idiots would literally miss her door, which would be the first door. I don't understand. Her door is as soon as you come up. Like literally there's a garage door, which we would leave open. You come up, it's her door. And then you come up again, it's my door. I don't understand why, but these people would sometimes purposely miss her door and come all the way up to my door. Just like how my bell was always the top bell, but for whatever reason, they would purposely miss her bell at the bottom and just ring my bell. Make it make fucking sense, because I don't fucking see it. Sundia, my best friend who has been on this channel before, actually brought up a very, very interesting point, saying that maybe they were trying to case my house or maybe they were trying to do something to me. And honestly, I really don't want to think about that, because that really actually scares me and pisses me the fuck off and really makes me think maybe, because like there were times where it just didn't make sense. Like, you guys are at her house all the time. Why the fuck are y'all ringing my doorbell and like really like knocking on my door on a consistent basis? It doesn't make any fucking sense. Like, the girl lives on the first fucking floor. You literally are passing her house to come up to mine. For what? They put these people on the same lease. Now, this is why this is important. So as you can imagine, all the people who live in the middle and the ground floor know each other. They're friends, because essentially you can't rent in the middle and the ground floor unless you know each other. So if you were to fuck around and snag one of these apartments, you'd have to know someone. They would be like, hey, do you know someone that wants to rent an apartment? You'd be like, yeah, my cousin, my sister, my mother, my brother. And be like, oh, okay, yeah, I know somebody that wants to rent this shit. Let me call them. And you would rent it with them. In theory, right? And clearly, that's how they got the rest of these shits fucking rented. So, of course, now we have everybody filled over here. We have Legover, Pushover, Ivana. Now, let's move on over to the next side. We have Shadow. Now, there's not much to say about Shadow because she's Shadow. I never met this girl. Until the end, and we're gonna get into her a little later because Jesus Christ. Then we have the Trap House. Okay, we got Trap Queen. She the Trap Queen and in the middle. We got Trap Queen, and then we got Grandma. Okay, I personally do not understand the type of rativity that was going on over there, but they're the reason that that whole establishment is that damn bad. The reason that a lot of this bullshit was going on is mainly because of them. A lot of the police activity that I thought was just plain old gentrification, I'm thinking that the cops are there to monitor the living establishment to make sure we safe, you know. I'm thinking, oh yes, yes, the cops are here to protect us, to make sure that the gentrification is taking place, you know. Naive old me, naive old little Ivana to think, oh my God, gentrification is really happening. Come to find, there's a whole trap house going on over there. And people in the hood have been complaining, saying that there's lots of drug and criminal activity going on in that unit. Do you know how bad you have to be for people in the hood to complain about you? Now we got the whole situation with Grandma. Now Grandma, again, completely quiet, ain't know nothing about it. Ain't know nothing about Grandma. Mind you, I haven't even seen Grandma's face. Meanwhile, Trap House got the whole hallway looking like a fucking mini project in the making. Okay, I went in there, this shit smelled like straight weed. It's just gray as fuck in there. The walls is white, shit looking like storm clouds in there. Nah, that shit gray. I don't understand. I feel bad for Shadow. And that's the first I heard of it, because I heard Shadow was sitting there complaining that Trap Queen and her people have also been blocking her driveways and shit. I heard that she was complaining that these people were always blocking her parking spot. And I had to pay attention, because I'm like, I'm always home, but I never really look out my window. And then I started paying attention and I realized, oh shit, they really are always blocking her parking spot. Not only are they always blocking her parking spot, but they was sitting there blocking her parking spot, like legit dealing drugs in her parking spot. I witnessed this shit, like literally bag out just dealing drugs in her parking spot. It's just like really bad. How the fuck, this shit don't make no sense. My thing is when people do it, like y'all so fucking ruthless with the shit that y'all do. Like if you're gonna like do things, can you at least be conspicuous? Can you at least be like a little bit more discreet? These people would just sit there, sell drugs, not give a fuck, just be out in the open with it. And I just felt so bad for these people because they just be out here working, coming home. Like that's how bad. I've never seen them. Like I knew they lived there because sometimes I would see them and I'm like, oh, these must be the girls. But like I never registered that it was Shadow until this whole situation. Now the thing is with Trap Queen is she's another one just like push over. My baby give me push over. Okay, push over. And Trap Queen also lied, talk about some, oh, it's only me and my child. Meanwhile, clearly there's illegal tenants there, okay? So Pushover as well as Trap Queen had a whole bunch of illegal tenants. Both of them had a whole heap of people over there that were clearly illegal tenants. Okay, I kid you not, there was a whole bunch of different names on both of their mailboxes at one time. I guess until people, even on Pushover's mailbox, there was different last names on there. Same thing with Trap House and Trap Queen. First of all, on Trap Queen's mailbox, that shit is practically hanging off the hinges. Why? It's been less than a year. Why the fuck is shit hanging off the hinges? Like, that's ridiculous. Why are y'all breaking shit already? Like, this is absolutely ridiculous and pathetic. And the reason why I know there's illegal tenants and Pushover shit is because there's times where all of these random people are saying hi and bye to me and they don't fucking live there. Make it make sense. Now, the people in the other unit, which is this corner unit, there's like a corner unit that kind of like, it's part of us, but it's like kind of wraps around the corner. I don't know nothing about these people. Nothing about them, never seen them, never nothing. But I know that they are Karens as fuck. Every time something was going down, anytime there was an altercation, they was the first ones. If the cops was there, it was probably their fault. They was the ones that was calling the cops every day. I love them, okay? They was not playing. They was like, there's some ghetto activity going on. Can you find out what's going on? Michael, can you please find out what's going on? They were not playing no games. Now that we have a good synopsis of the people that I'm living around, let's go through the whole heap of issues. Let's get into the excessive guests, illegal tenants. Pushover. The reason I'm calling her pushover is because she blatantly allowed all of these people to live or stay a long time, okay? I feel like they were illegal tenants. And I'm gonna say legal tenants because there are times where I see people coming into her house with keys. I'm talking about men, women, children, whatever, just coming into her house all hours, all times of the night, okay? I'm talking about with sacks of clothes. I'm talking about, like, I'm dead serious. I know she doesn't have a laundry, but it just doesn't make sense how these people are coming into her house at all times of the day, all times of the night. And they saying hi to me. They knocking on my door. They're ringing my doorbell. They have garage access regularly. The only person that comes to my house on a regular basis is my man. And it's mainly on weekends. Okay, sometimes he would come during the week, like once or twice. Okay, but he's not there every day. I don't understand how it makes sense to you as a person with a toddler to have these people consistently over your house on a regular basis. Not to mention the excessive partying. When I first moved to this apartment, this girl was partying at least 2 to 3 times a week. And I just didn't understand it. I'm like, first of all, do you not work? Second of all, do you not care about your fucking kid? Now, what really makes me upset about this is she was having these parties. And I literally would hear these parties up until 3, 4 o'clock in the morning. And I remember it got to the point where I had to text Michael, like, yo, could you tell Pushover to keep it down? That shit pissed me off so fucking much. Because one time she had a party to the point where they were fighting at this party. And I could hear the fight in my fucking walk-in closet. And I was so mad to the point where the next day, I remember I was with my boyfriend. My boyfriend was sleeping over that night. And I literally walked out with my boyfriend because we were going somewhere that day. And she saw me.
Like, oh my God, girl, was me loud last night, yo.
And I just looked at her like, and I know my boyfriend looked at me like, Ivana, please. Like, listen, the thing is, me and my boyfriend have a very interesting dynamic, okay? Think of a dog, okay? I'm the bark and he's the leash, okay? He's like, and I'm like, that is our relationship. So he's just like, Ivana, yield. And I'm like, so I put my little muzzle on and I just, I literally just looked at her like.
And she's like, oh my God, girl. Yeah, it was annoying me too. Like, you know, we was having a party. Like, you know, my uncle just got out of jail. So, you know.
My thing is, as a woman with a kid, with a toddler, the fact that you were comfortable having all of these people in your house, right, whether the kid was present or not, which I'm sure they were, because, like, I heard a bunch of kids in the house, like, I'm sure they just threw the kids in a room, like, party on the outside or something. That's exactly what it sounded like. And my thing is, what, having all these people in your house, like, how can you feel comfortable? Like, do you not care about the safety of your kids? Do you not care about, like, what can happen with all of these kids in one room unsupervised? Like, I just don't understand. And she continued to have these parties on a regular, consistent basis. So I'm just like, you know what? I could already tell what type of time this girl is on, and I'm not even about to do this shit right now. Like, at this point, I was very fucking annoyed with this girl, and I was like, yeah, I don't want to fuck with this girl. I'm not about to deal with it. At this point, I was like, I'm not even about to say nothing because I want to seem like that type of person. She continued to have these parties. I continued to tell Michael, tell her to keep it down. Tell her to keep it down. Tell her to keep it down. The music, the noise, the whatever, barely did anything. Now, let me just tell you guys right now, please remember, I'm upstairs. Understand, when you are upstairs in an apartment or anything, you should never hear shit. This is why people live upstairs in apartments because they don't want to be bothered, right? They don't want to hear anything. If I'm upstairs, I shouldn't hear anything. There's no reason why I should be able to hear anything that is going on when I'm upstairs from you, idiot. So I'm just sitting here so fucking annoyed that this bitch has the nerve to go out, the audacity to be having these parties in a pandemic with a fucking kid. I really thought that when I heard that this girl was a woman with a kid, like, that I would be at peace. I was like, oh my God, yes, a mom with a kid and we're in a pandemic. No one should be having parties. You have a kid. You have a toddler at that. This should not be something I should be worried about, not be something I should be concerned of. And then on top of that, your guests are sitting here constantly ringing my doorbell, constantly knocking on my door, constantly pissing me the fuck off. Like, y'all, I don't think you understand the amount of fucking mad I was, but like, this was something that like really pissed me off. Like, she's constantly having get together. So you guys can imagine, every time I wanted to film, every time I wanted to go live, every time I wanted to do this, that, and the third, I couldn't because she's partying, having a get together. She's being loud. She's doing this, that, and the third. And it's like, are y'all really dead ass right now? Are y'all really dead ass? And I'm a very quiet person. You do not see me. These people didn't know my name. These people didn't have my number. I was very out of the way. The most you can say is you probably hear me fucking filming. Shit, you probably hear me fucking. That's the most. But you're not gonna see me. You're not gonna hear me. I'm out of sight and out of fucking mind. Okay? I don't have time for that goofy shit. I work, I sleep, and I go away. You're not gonna see me, bruh. I don't have time for that. I'm about my business, not about my money. When you start interfering with that shit, I start getting really, really mad. How hard is it to be fucking quiet? Even if you're gonna play your music and you're gonna live your life, do you have to do it that loud and do you have to do it that consistent, right? Like, you don't have to have parties every day and every week and every weekend. Like, when the fuck do you work? Like, from what I understand, these people work that night, like, all of them work night shifts. Maybe they worked at Amazon or something like that. But like, goddamn. What really made me mad is her guests would sit there and fucking block the driveway and block my parking spot. Why do you think it makes sense to block my fucking parking spot? I just need to understand this logic, right? If I have an emergency or if I'm gonna come in, why does it make sense to block my parking spot? Now, the thing is, my street was extremely narrow to the point where if you were coming somewhere or you had somewhere to be on my street, you have to just go where you need to go. Because if you don't, you're going to be blocking the street and you're going to be creating an excessive amount of traffic. Not to mention, we're in Newark where people don't recognize stop sign and don't recognize speed limits. So if you don't go where you need to go, you're going to get hit. And I don't know if these people don't understand that concept, but clearly they don't. Because these people just doop, doop, doop. They would just come, they would just go, they would just... So my thing is, if I'm just coming and my shit is blocked, are you dumb or are you stupid? And there was one time I literally just pulled in and a whole fucking mommy van is blocking my shit. I don't know if they were having a freaking like baby shower or some sort, but I literally started tweaking. Like, I'm like, are y'all fucking serious? Like, I was so mad. And they're like,
oh, you coming in?
And I'm like, bruh. So I had to circle the block a couple times to wait for this person to fucking move their shit. Like, are you really serious, bro? And this happened a couple of times. I'm like, bruh, I really don't have time for this. Like, I shouldn't have to wait for people to move their shit because your shit shouldn't be there in the fucking first place. Then it became their friends doing this goofy shit, especially with their little illegal car wash, okay? So my thing is, if you put a car wash situation for your car in the garage, fine. But it gets to a point where you're gonna have shit in the car. You're gonna have shit in the garage for your friends to come and use, especially when you're not there. I have a problem with that. Why the fuck? I literally pulled up a couple weeks ago and this nigga literally was just washing his car, literally blocking the whole garage. Just do 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 do. Washing his car. I pull up. I'm literally pressing the thing.
Oh, you trying to come in?
But mind you, I was on speaker. I was on Bluetooth in my car. And I was talking to my cousin. I started screaming. Because mind you, I was at wit's end. Like, I'm at the end. I'm moving at this point. And I'm just like, there's nobody. Please don't tell me there's somebody blocking the garage. And I started, I'm like, what the fuck? What the fuck? And like, I know he had to hear me because I was so fucking annoyed. And he's like, oh, you try. He dressed. He's like, oh, you trying to come in? Like, you do you not see me moving the fucking garage with the fucking... He takes forever to move his car. And at this point, I don't give a fuck. I park my car in the middle of the street. I park my car. And I'm waiting. I'm like, nope. And I get out the car and I'm just looking at him like, mind you, what really made me mad is there was plenty of space. So I'm like, all right, you want to be stupid? I can be stupid too. So everybody gonna be inconvenienced today. Luckily, there was plenty of space on the street, but I don't give a fuck. Everybody gonna be inconvenienced today. Mind you, he was mumbling the whole time, so the only thing I understand was my
bad, sweetheart.
I thought that one, like when niggas mumble rap, that was just like a rapping persona type of thing. That nigga was mumbling the whole time. All I heard was my bad, sweetheart. Everything else was, I didn't hear anything else that nigga said. I didn't hear anything he said. I did not know mumble rap was a real language.
But all I heard was my bad, sweetheart.
I don't have time for that goofy shit. These motherfuckers, bro. Like, first of all, why are people having access to the garage and to the apartment situation when you're not here? That's extremely concerning. I hate to be that person. However, I am a public figure. There's other people who live here, and you're just giving people willy-nilly access to people's living quarters without you being there. That's very scary. That's unacceptable. That's not okay. The constant domestic disputes. Now, as I said, the cops were always around. Like I said, I thought it was gentrification, but apparently, it was definitely a trap house going on next door. So, of course, the cops were there for that. But the domestic disputes were definitely because of them as well. Now, like I said, the trap queen was definitely causing the problems along with her little trap homies. But also, there was a whole situation going on with the grandma. Now, the reason I called grandma is because she is also the grandmother of the trap queen's kids. So like I said, I told you everyone has a relationship with one another. So everyone that rents the bottom unit as well as the middle unit is friends with one another or has some sort of relationship to one another. There's unit 1, 2, 3. So what we're gonna say is I'm in unit 2. Okay, I'm in unit 2, so we're gonna call them unit 3 over here. So we got trap queen and grandma. So trap queen and grandma are related. Because trap queen is the baby mother of grandma's son. And they decided to go in a lease together. Now, this makes no fucking logical sense because technically that's the only thing that ties them together. She not married to your son, but for whatever reason, you thought it made sense to be on the same lease as her. That is the most stupid thing I've ever seen or ever heard in my entire life. That makes no goddamn sense. Fucking stupid. People, y'all need to learn to stop being in relations or in serious contracts or any type of agreements with people that don't have any type of legal ties to you. I know divorce is happening and all, but like, a baby mother agreement is not a good one. The grandmother and the baby mother are beefing because apparently the baby mother is now bringing over her new nigga around the kids, and the grandmother is not okay with that. So if you guys are not following, listen again. The baby mother is in a lease agreement with her baby father's mom. Baby father's mother lives in the ground level apartment, and they are both on the same lease because apparently the property manager thinks it makes sense to put everybody that lives in the ground level and the middle level apartments together on the same lease. Makes no fucking sense, but that's how it is for all of those apartments. So when they got into the lease agreement together, she agreed, okay, trap queen agreed that she would not bring any new men around. You know, she's single, she focused on herself, she wouldn't do that. However, clearly she broke that agreement and she moved in her new man as well as his kids into that apartment. So now there's been all this major conflict and all of these problems, and now she being petty. Not only is there a trap house, but she got her new nigga there, she got the kids there, she got her kid there, the grandkid of grandma. But on top of that, she got a trap house running. So you can imagine drugs, the grandbaby, the boyfriend, his kids. There's a full house going over there. There's too much going on over there. That's probably where the roach is coming from. Let's be fucking real. And to add petty on the cake, she's purposely not paying rent. trying to be petty to get back at the grandmother for voicing her opinions at her dismay of the whole situation. And as you guys can imagine, since everybody's on the same lease, even though grandma's still paying her rent on time, she's still affected by it because they're still on the same lease. Ridiculous. You can't make this shit up. Because so since this shit has happened, there's been constant domestic complaints that cops have had to been called. People around the neighborhood have been complaining and been literally upset about, you know, the police presence, because they're like, you know what, all of this ghetto-ness is going on, you guys have to rectify this, you guys are bringing cops around, dot, dot, dot. And I'm just like, this is ridiculous and this is ghetto. What's funny is these people are so fucking loud to the point where you can literally hear them yelling and causing all of this ruckus and all of these problems through my screen door. Now the thing is, my screen door is very much so soundproof, and the fact that you can hear that shit is very insane because it's soundproof. If you can scream through that, you're fucking loud, bro. I can hear a car accident and that shit sounds like crumpling cans. Okay, I can hear gunshots and that shit just sounds like a thump. Okay, so the fact that you can scream through that shit, you loud as hell. Okay, there was a time where, like, my best friend Teach came over and we was hearing a full-blown argument that these niggas was happening. Not through the wall, but through the glass, okay? Through the glass, and we was able to record that shit through the story. Like, we were literally recording it and we both put it on our IG story. Like, oh my god, bro, that shit funny as hell. Like, somebody going through it, bro. Da, 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 da. Like, that shit hilarious. And I remember, we didn't even have to open the glass to hear that shit. That's how loud they were. Like, come on now. Like, this shit, it's just ridiculous. It's a problem. The heightened police presence, it's just really ridiculous. I remember one time, I guess Pushover definitely put her foot down. Yes, this is what we're calling her, Pushover. Not too long ago, maybe a month or so ago, I did hear her finally having an argument with someone and telling someone to get the fuck out of her house. And lately, I have seen her have less people. Clearly, she definitely does have an illegal tenant over there, which is like her sister, I think. Called Michael. I was like, Michael. He literally told me, like, yeah, I think there's illegal tenants there. I was like, well, clearly. He was like, well, how do you know? I'm like, so you know that the only people that's supposed to be down there, living there, right, is supposed to be her and her son. He was like, yeah. I said, don't you see there's a little girl's bike in the garage? Like, oh, I was like, yeah, she has a son, and there's two, there's a little boy's bike and a little girl's bike. He's like, oh, yeah, you're right. I was like, yeah, and her car's always parked right out front in the same exact spot regularly. He's like, oh, I was like, yeah, certain things are common sense, just common fucking sense. The heightened police presence, like, I feel like the police have literally been around trying to catch this trap house, but like, they really haven't. And honestly, I feel like they're doing such a horrible job. Like, I should be a fucking cop. Like, I'm telling you guys, there's been so many times where they could have caught them, but it's like they come here at the most horrible times. There's been time the cops was blocking my fucking driveway and I'm like, nigga, wrong fucking house, bro. There's one time they pulled my man over and literally gave him fucking tickets for his tents. Now, let me just let you guys know right now, right? Tents are illegal in New Jersey on certain windows. Like, you can have them on your back windows, but not your front. But they will never pull you over for tents. It's usually like an additional ticket. You run a stop sign, they'll give you that. And then they're like, oh, and you have tents, ticket. Or it's like, oh, you don't have a seatbelt on and you have tents, oh, ticket. You know, it's never like a, oh, we pulled you over for your tent. It's one of those things where I'm very sure he was parked like very close to that one, to like that house, and they saw his car and they were like, oh, all right, bet. And he kind of matches the description of one of those niggas that lives over there. So I'm very sure they saw him and thought he was one of them and they pulled him over for that. And it's getting to the point where it's like, yeah, this is getting fucking annoying because these niggas be doing too much goofy shit. And it's funny because recently there was this whole situation where I'm very sure and I'm very adamant that they really want to run down on that unit, but they were this close, but not quite. When I first came to this place, like I said, it was clear, it was fine. I saw no issues. Everything looked pretty empty. It didn't look like anything was really going on, but again, I came early. When you pull up to the hood early, there's nothing that's gonna be going on because all the problems usually happen from late afternoon to nighttime. When I typed it into GPS, I got there just fine. However, I realized every time I gave the address to other people, they could not get to my fucking address. It was very strange to me. I thought that everyone was just stupid. I also realized that everyone else was using Google Maps, meanwhile I was using Waze. But then I realized even though when other people were using Waze, they could not get to my address. So I didn't understand what the meaning of this was. So when I would order food, when I would order Amazon, when I would order anything, it would not get to my fucking house. So I came to the conclusion that I just could not order anything to my house because my shit was not registered properly because it was a new address that was freaking registered during COVID. So as you guys can imagine, I could not get anything delivered to my house the entire time I lived there. So you guys cannot understand how frustrating this was, especially when I brought it up to my property manager and he would sit there and be like,
well, no one else is having problems.
Michael, I don't understand. What part of I don't give a fuck about anybody else do you not understand? I care about Ivana having problems. Ivana's paying the most rent. Ivana's the only one paying rent on time, and Ivana is having problems. Everybody else can suck my ass. I don't give a fuck. Okay, like this shit is pissing me off because it's like I have to live off of my P.O. box. If I was not an influencer with a P.O. box right now, I would not give a fuck about what you're talking about. I literally could sit here and not pay rent because I don't have a working address right now. It got to the point where I would call PSENG and I'm sitting here trying to register my utilities to me so I can pay them. And they're telling me my address doesn't exist. I'm sitting here trying to tell them this is my address. I'm trying to assume responsibilities in my utilities and they're telling me,
are you sure? It's showing up as an empty lot.
Bitch, and he's literally sitting there like,
are you sure? We had a problem before, but it shouldn't be a problem now. Everyone else is having an issue.
Else. This was a problem the entire time up to the point where literally right before I was gonna move, like 2 to 3 weeks ago, I finally got a bill and the bill was legit $1,000+ because I could not pay my utilities. I called PSENG at least 3 or 4 separate times to try to get this fucking bill. So to be quite honest with you, I don't want to hear shit. And that was like my last straw because no one thought that it made sense that somehow, some way, that the address was not properly registered. Meanwhile, everybody else could get shit. I never saw any packages, really. It shipped here. And shockingly, that came. I had an IRS mail shipped here. Shockingly, that came. But other than that, nothing else that I ever had was ever shipped here. Like, I barely got a bill here. I barely had anything else shipped here. If anything else was ever mailed here, it probably never got here. My address was never properly registered. I was trying to do my media hustle launch. I literally had my shit mailed here, right? I did not want to go all the way to my P.O. box, right? My P.O. box is in Elizabeth. Not too far, but just sometimes you just want to just get the easy way out, right? Why the fuck was it that I tried to get my shit mailed here and it got delivered to a whole nother address? Now, mind you, the address that this shit is registered to, when you put that address in, is it's two different addresses, y'all, which is very weird. It will either go to one house on one end of the street or another house on the opposite end of the street. So luckily, when Amazon delivers your package, it does take a picture. So I followed the picture. I walked up and down the street to figure out what house it would deliver to. And I found the fucking house. And I went and I took my package off of the damn stoop. And I finally realized what house all my shit was getting delivered to. And I'm like, this is fucking ridiculous. And it is absurd. This is not what should be fucking happening. So I went, I picked up the package, and then I looked at another time when I tried to get shit delivered. It was a whole nother house on the opposite end of the street. And I'm like, you know what? This is just unacceptable. Of course, my cell phone service. Now, upon moving in, I realized my service was horrible. What I'm telling you guys, horrible? Horrible. Now, when I was first moving in, I brought a couple of boxes. This was my equipment. This is something I usually do. I don't trust movers with my equipment, except for this time, and now I fucking regret it. Story time coming soon, as I said. Quite honest with you, I tried to take a story. I remember I was like, hi guys, this is my apartment, da da da. And when I got in the car, I realized none of the stories posted. I was very fucking confused. Okay, must be just like, you know, a temporary thing. When I finally moved, I realized my calls were dropping, my shit was glitching, and I'm like, oh shit, like I have no bars here. This can't be good. And it got increasingly worse. I'm calling Verizon, I'm upping my data. I literally got to the highest fucking plan, the cheapest fucking plan. I literally was selling my soul for my phone to work, and it wasn't working. And I have Verizon. Verizon is literally very expensive, and it wasn't working. And I'm like, oh my Lord, this is horrible. So literally, I had to live without service for a long time. And then it got to a point where I had to just live off of Wi-Fi. Now, Optimum was taking forever to come install service because they claimed they had no installation dates. And the Optimum service was disgustingly horrible in this area. Like, when I'm telling you horrible, horrible. Optimum was already not that great, but it was really bad. Like, bad. Like, I'm talking about service dropping every couple of days bad. Had to reset my router every couple of days bad. So, you guys can imagine, as a YouTuber, how bad my service was. Coupled with the fact that my mental health was shit because I had to move out of nowhere and I had to deal with these fucking neighbors doing the most, I was fucking annoyed as shit. So now I had to go and get an extender. So Verizon, I had to send an extender to my house so I can extend my data for my phone. So fun fact, guys, a lot of Verizon customer service people don't know what the fuck they're doing, okay? They don't know what they're doing, and they most likely are gonna try to say that they can't help you when they can. If someone knows what the fuck they're doing, they will send you a extender that is able to extend your Verizon data that basically enhances your server in your house or in your area so that your phone will work better. I spent weeks, okay, I'm telling you, weeks on customer service calls with my phone calls dropping, might I add, trying to fix my cell service. And literally, it just connects to your router and it makes your life so much easier. But mind you, I had Optimum. So you guys are probably wondering, how the fuck did you get them to come to your building? Because I did not have files. Mind you, this is a brand new building. So y'all, I had to beg files to come over here. You know, one of those people that be sitting there like in Walmart, Costco and everything, trying to like get you to sign up for service, you know, and all that. I had to get one of them to come and get files in my building. So honestly, at least these like Cutco people, you know, these like, you know, these scammers or whatever that be trying to like do these little pyramid scheme jobs, they are good for something, because those people really helped me get Verizon files into my building. I had to do all of that. I was sitting there telling Michael, please, can you get files? Can you please tell them to come do the survey? Because that's the only way to get files in your building. You have to tell them to come do the survey for your building, and then they have to come do the wiring, blah, blah. It's a whole fucking thing. And every time I told Michael to do, he's like,
yeah, I'm on it, I'm gonna do it, I'm on it.
This bitch ass, dusty ass nigga didn't do shit. To be completely honest, I did the legwork. I did all of that shit to get files. And it's very important for me to get really good, stable connection, because I'm a YouTuber. I am a person that works on social media. I cannot be having shitty ass fucking service. So yes, I did that work. And what made me more annoyed is when I got files over here, he just happened to pull up to the building that day, and he's sitting there telling everybody in the building,
ooh, yeah, we have files now. If you want files, we have files now.
Bitch, fuck you. Okay, fuck you. I did that work. Don't be out here telling everybody that we got files now. No, no. Bitch, I did that work. Fuck you. And no, like no. Fuck them. They can stay with their shitty ass Optimum. Don't be telling niggas that we got, shut the fuck up, little Ninja Turtle looking ass, bitch ass nigga. That shit had me mad as fuck. Like, no, like, don't be out here trying to tell niggas that we got this after. No, I got it. We ain't get shit. I ain't got it. I should be the property manager at this point. I had to install a Ring camera in my house because it got to a point where I was low-key scared, thinking that something could have literally happened, because I really thought that maybe someone was going to break into my house. I started having nightmares. I really was thinking like, okay, someone could have broke into my house eventually. Someone could have did something. Someone could have like, I really was thinking like someone was like literally like watching me at some point, because like I just kept having a really bad feeling that something bad was going to eventually happen to me. Like, and no one should live like that. It comes to a point where like living in the hood really does make you paranoid, and I really did become extremely paranoid and extremely like scared, because it was not a good situation, and I don't believe anyone should live like that. And now I know why people in the hood never make it out the hood, because I feel like eventually you just become extremely comfortable. You know, you get, oh well, I've always lived like this. Oh well, you know, I don't have to leave, you know, I can't afford it, If you can't afford it, get the fuck out. If you can find a better place, get the fuck out. Live with family, live with friends, get a roommate, get the fuck out. This is no place for anyone. If you can find a better community, a better place, anything, get the fuck out. I'm telling you right now, this is not conducive environment. I was very, very stunted. I very, very much so felt very trapped. I felt isolated. I felt very, very suffocated. I never in my life took so many breaks, felt so very much so horrible. Like, I honestly haven't felt this bad since I lived back in the hood. And it's funny, like, when I lived with my parents, I did live in the hood. Like, I grew up in the hood and I did feel bad. I definitely did feel bad. And it brought me back to feeling that bad. But even at that, I didn't feel that bad. It's hard to explain. Like, I felt bad living in the hood, but not this bad, not to this extent. But I was also very comfortable in that hood. This hood, I don't think I could have ever felt that type of fucking comfortable. And even at that, it's like, this is not something that I would probably wish on anyone. Like, it was just very fucking annoying. It really was. And I could not get anything done. And I think that's what really annoyed me. I do not like anything fucking with my productivity at all. I was just extremely unproductive and I just could not. That just brings me to my last and final fucking straw, and that was when I literally gave my deposit to this place. So I was live on Bego. Right after I got off of live on Bego, I was washing up, I was getting dressed to go to sleep, I was putting on my pajamas or whatever, I go to sleep, and I was hearing thumping, like literally like a, and I'm thinking someone is like knocking on my door per usual, because like I said, this bitch's guests be literally knocking on my door, ringing my doorbell, doing all this goofy shit all times of the day, all times of the night. I'm not joking and I'm not over fucking exaggerating. Go to the door window situation, you know, like the big screen door thing, and I'm just looking and I see a circus. People screaming, people yelling, and I'm like, what in the ghetto is going on here? And I see this white girl, I don't know, she could have been white, she could have been Spanish, she could have been mixed, and she's like, oh, for some pussy, bitch, oh, for some pussy, and I'm like, what? It's too early for this shit. And at this point, everybody's up. Like, I feel like the whole neighborhood is up, because like, everybody's lights is coming on, like, it's mad to go outside, like, everyone's scattering, people getting in their car, I see people holding people back, and I should have started filming then, but I was just trying to understand the scene, and I was trying to understand, is this downstairs, is this next door, is this people from, like, what's going on? All of a sudden, now all the police start pulling up. Someone's getting arrested on the left, someone's getting arrested on the right. I'm like, ooh, this is bad. Now I see Shadow. But at this point, I didn't know that that was Shadow. I thought it was Track Queen. And Shadow is literally screaming, coming out, arguing with this white girl. The white girl's getting pulled by some dude. Dude's throwing her in the car. And it gets to a point where Shadow's being held back by some other girl. Shadow's being sat down on the sidewalk. Shadow's trying to buck back at the police officer. Police officer's putting the hand on the clip. And to be honest with you, I thought I was about to be witness to a crime of, oh my lord, Shadow's about to become a hashtag. Honestly, if this was anywhere else, that cop would have made an example out of her, because Shadow was sitting here pushing the cop, screaming at the cop, doing the most. And I'm like, she would have became a hashtag if it was anywhere else. Luckily, newer cops not about to make an example out of her, but anywhere else would have definitely made an example out of her and would have definitely dragged that girl, would have definitely tried. It would have been bad. But luckily that didn't happen, because child, like, she was literally like bucking at the cop. And that was because apparently she was talking about some,
what did they say is in my mama car? What did they say is in my mama car?
What is in your mama car? I wonder what's in your mama car. Like, it was so weird. Like, I didn't understand why she didn't want them to check her mama's car. Because what's in your mama car, sis? It was so strange, because it was like whoever they was arresting was basically like snitching on her. It looked like one of her friends snitched on her and was saying something was in her mama car. But something had to be in her mama car, because child. And what's funny is the cops never even checked her mama's car. They were checking the other cars that were on the street because they were open or something. Or maybe they had a warrant or some sort. But they didn't look like they had a warrant, but they never checked her mama's car. They only checked the other car. So it was like she was doing all that, was literally potentially about to lose her own life, but they didn't even check that car. It was so fucking funny. But what's funnier is they literally pulled up so deep, guys. It was like literally like 10 cop cars. I'm not joking. Mad cops. Like, it was a lot of cops. It was at least 8. I would say 10, but it was probably at least very minimally 8 cops that pulled up. And they all went into the freaking house next door. And I'm thinking it's the trap house, but it wasn't. It was Shadow's house. And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, come to find the whole time at the end, that's when I found out it wasn't Trap Queen. It was Shadow. And I'm like, wow. And Michael was like, well, I don't care. I'm using them as an example, and they all got to get out now. I don't give a fuck. They're bringing too much police activity, so they're all going to have to get out, yada, yada. They ended up getting evicted. So they had to leave anyway. And apparently there was a whole thing conjuring anyway, where she got into a whole altercation with her other roommate, and someone else was supposed to move in this month anyhow. And it was a whole debacle with that. So there was already a situation, trust me. So I really don't care, and I really don't feel bad. I'll tell you that. But recently there was a whole nother situation where there was a whole bunch of teen kids yet again that was just running rampant in the street, just yelling and screaming in the street again, jumping on cars, banging on windows. I just don't fucking understand. This is what made me realize that this man does not vet these people whatsoever when he rents these apartments. Okay. So I was out of there. I found a place. I'm out of there because at this point I was just so fucking over it. I made an appointment with Michael to give the keys back literally a couple days ago, right? July 1st. Why the fuck? I was running a little late because I have a key organizer, right? So the key organizer, you kind of have to have like a screwdriver to like take it apart to take the keys, right? Why the fuck did I take the keys apart or whatever to get the keys out? And I pull up to the apartment and I see this nigga with two people, and it was like a couple, and I'm confused because I was not aware. I thought I'm supposed to meet up with him to give the keys back and do a walkthrough, right? So when you give an apartment back, when you give keys back, when you're like literally giving possession of the apartment back, that's what you're supposed to do. Why the fuck he got two people with him? I'm confused as fuck. I'm supposed to just do walkthrough. I told Michael since April, I want to leave this apartment. I'm done with you guys. I'm not renewing the lease. Every time I told this man something was wrong, he literally met it with a no one else is complaining, da da da. And the thing that pisses me off about this is I don't give a fuck about anyone else. And I tried to tell him, either lower the rent, fix these issues, or I'm out. No one wanted to listen to me. No one wanted to lower the rent, whatever. I don't give a fuck. That's fine. I'm leaving then. Don't give a fuck. Let me just tell you this right now. No one saw this apartment. I told him, let me know if you want someone to look at the apartment. Just let me know in advance so I can know so I can tell you guys when I'm gonna be home, or I can know to be home at these specific times that this person wants to come see it. No one saw it. April, May, June 30th, I moved out. No one came to see this apartment at all. Not a soul, not virtually, not physically. Why I pull up to give the keys back on July 1st and he's with two people? I'm confused as fuck. So I'm just sitting there like, okay, I'm thinking maybe it's a viewing. Okay, so I was a little late and I'm confused. Aren't you the property manager? Why the fuck don't you have the keys? Why you got these people fucking standing here?
Property fucking manager? He's like, oh, you know, well, you know, I have a lot of properties I'm in and then I have the keys.
I'm not about to go through that with you. That's literally what I said. I said, that's pathetic. I'm not about to go through that with you. I mean, open the door, whatever. And you know, he's like, yeah, you know, it's a lot of space, da da da. She's like, yeah, I need a lot of space, because, you know, I think she had kids or whatever. She's like, yeah, I have kids, so I need a lot of space, and she kept saying. And I'm like, that's interesting. I'm like, oh, well, it's a lot of space for me, because, you know, it's just me, da da, but it is a lot of space. But I'm like, the thing is, that apartment was low-key an illusion. I feel like since everything was like pure white, it made it feel like a lot bigger. But it's funny, like coming here, I felt like it was a downsize. It is a downsize because the rooms are smaller. Thinking about it, looking at it, and thinking about it, it wasn't that much smaller, and it wasn't that much bigger. In square footage, and realistically looking and thinking, these apartments are virtually the same exact size, but the sizing is distributed a lot differently. So, yeah. We'll see. I don't know. Like, honestly, in that apartment, a lot of the space was distributed in the master bedroom. And since she's saying that she wants a lot of space, unless she's gonna fuck around and put one of the kids in her master bedroom, I don't know what she's about to do. But the girl did not seem that impressed with the apartment. But nonetheless, why the fuck did he pass her the keys? Yes, ladies and gentlemen, no one saw this apartment at all. Passed her the keys. And I'm just like, oh my god, these people signed their life away without even seeing the apartment. Jesus fucking Christ. Without looking at the area, without seeing the apartment, I'm like, oh my god. I'm just sitting there like, I was like, no, they didn't. Child. So I'm like, okay, maybe they got time. Maybe it's just lease signing. Child, why the fuck we go downstairs and they start moving shit in? Child, I'm like, what? And she started saying that she's from Brooklyn, you know, she moved to Newark, you know, she's been there for a couple of years. So I'm like, okay, maybe she used to ghetto, but I'm like, I don't know if she's about to be used to this type of fucking ghetto. And she got kids. I don't fucking know, bro. I'm scared for her. I'm very scared for her. But I'm like, I don't know. So I'm just sitting here like, I have no idea how she's about to deal with this right now. Like, I'm scared. I'm really scared. So at this point, I'm like, you know what? Let's really see. So as we walk outside, you know, I'm talking to Michael and he's like, yeah, you know, I'm really thinking about getting cameras, you know, because of everything you said, you know, that's been going on here. You know, I'm going to put cameras in the hallway. I'm going to put cameras in the front. Kid you not, as soon as we're talking about this, the owner of a restaurant that works across the street comes up to us. He's like, hey, Michael, do you have cameras? Okay. And he's like, no, I don't have cameras installed. Why? He goes, yeah, last night around 10:30, my car was stolen. Yeah, he has that accent, guys. Sorry. Love the Jamaican accent. It's so cute. And he was like, what? No, what do you mean? And the funny thing is, if you guys follow me on Beagle, I was live on Beagle that night in the old apartment because I had came back to get all of the food from the apartment because I didn't want it to melt because it was like 100 degrees the day before. And the people, the movers, were so fucking shitty that they left so much shit in the apartment and I had to come back and get the food, as well as it was like thunderstorm. It was like a really bad rainstorm. So I'm like, they stole your car? I'm like, if they stole your car, I would have definitely saw it. Like, that's mad strange. I'm like, that means they were like so slick and very quick with the shit. Yeah, like I had my baby in the car. I took the baby, I covered it with a blanket, and I went into the restaurant, and as soon as I turned around, because I was gonna give someone a ride, like the car was gone. And it's like, this is my second Infiniti they stole. First of all, second Infiniti? This is the second time you have an Infiniti. First of all, you have a restaurant. So clearly they were watching you. Second of all, second Infiniti? All I have is a key. I said, so this will push to start. You left the push to start running. Not to be an asshole, but like, why are you driving your Infiniti to a hood where you own a business? When you own a business in the hood, you drive your Subaru, nigga. You drive your Toyota. You drive your Honda. You drive your Nissan. Nigga, what the fuck is you doing? Like, of course it, Papa. You just wanted your car to fucking get stolen. You sitting here trying to flex on niggas in the hood when you own a business. The fuck, they've been watching your duck ass. Like, what are you doing? So I'm just like, yo, I feel real bad for you. Like, this is so fucked up. He's like, nah, like, yeah, this is ridiculous. And he's upset. Like, he's really upset. He's like, yeah, you really should have cameras up here. Because, you know, your people that live in this building are conspiring with them. And I'm like, mind you, I was just sitting there like, so when I say it, every time I said something to Michael, he's like, oh, well, no one else is complaining. Nigga, they all friends, my nigga. They all friends. You rented to niggas that's all fucking friends. They're all cool with each other. They're the ones partying together. They're the ones doing these car washes together. They're the ones committing crimes together. They're the ones all together. Of course, they're not gonna fucking say shit. Of course, they're not the ones calling the cops. They're not the ones having these issues. They're the ones in cahoots, you dumb bitch. Oh my fucking God. He's like, oh, who? And he's like, oh, it's this girl. She lives here in this car and this man. Every time, when they stole my last car, I had them on camera, And it was this man and this car. He's literally describing them. And I know he knows what he's talking about because he's giving the right description with the right cars, with the right this and the right that. And I'm like, liberation, bro. Liberation. I'm like, yo, this some shit, bro. I was just like, yo, God, thank you. Thank you for helping me see this at the end. Because thank you. Final fucking Lee. I really hope he finds his car, though. I really do. Because that's really some fucked up shit. I'm just like, they stole your shit in the pouring rain. And I'm telling you, the rain was really bad that day. Like, thunder, lightning, pouring fucking rain. Like, we had a fucking flash flood warning. Don't leave the house type of warning that day. So, pitch black darkness. So, I don't understand. I'm like, damn, these people are ruthless. But it was a push to start, so I'm like, I'm very sure they can't get that far. And he said that the tank was practically empty, like it needed gas. With that Infiniti, and I believe most Infinities, like there's only a specific way you could put gas in it. And unless you have an Infiniti, there's no way you can know how to put gas in it. So he was like, yeah, I hope they don't know how to do that, da, da, da. And I'm like, well, we'll see. There's a bunch of criminals living in there. They're definitely in cahoots and they're conspiring together. Child, you ain't never lied. I'm so happy I got out of there because God knows what would have happened to me at this fucking point. It is what it is though. Thank you guys so much for watching this video and listening to my story of what I was going through for this past year and some change. That's definitely why I've been so absent. Never in my life have I posted this least amount of videos. Moral of the story, like I said, please research where you live. Don't just subject yourself to a lower quality of life just because the rent is cheaper. Do not sacrifice your quality of life. Always be a Karen if that's what you have to do to get what you want. Do not pay rent if you do not have to. Know your rights in terms of what you have to pay for and what you don't have to pay for. If something is not being handled properly, know your rights as a tenant. Know your rights as a human and understand that if you are not happy somewhere, you have the right to leave if things are not being fulfilled and people are not listening to you. And also, please understand that you are valuable as a person. And if you are not getting enough sleep, if you are not happy, if people are not listening to you, you have to be able and understand that you have to speak up about it. Because if you are not at your best, you're not going to be able to fulfill what you need to as a person. And all of that is gonna come tumbling down. If you cannot sleep, if you cannot eat, if you do not have access to the right things, eventually it's gonna all come tumbling down. Living in the hood, not having access to the right things, the potholes, you know, not enough good connection, all of that. I'm telling you, like, I never noticed how bad all of that shit is. Like, I never peeped how bad all of that is, but it really is. And I feel so bad for anyone that's like really in that type of environment on a very consistent basis, because it really does have a very, very, very bad effect on you, and it all trickles down. And child, I'm so sorry for anyone that was affected by any of like just my behavior for the past year and a half, because I was just so out of it. I just can't. And yeah, if you guys really made it to the end of this video, thank you guys so much for watching. Comment down any of your horrible neighbor story times. Thank you guys so much for rocking it out for me. And yes, the content is gonna be coming. I'm definitely gonna be doing a giveaway soon. Make sure you guys check the description box for more information. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, all of that. Get your merchandise. If you don't have a story, make sure you comment down a heart. And yeah, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye.